Hey guys, just wanted to do an update video on the discus tank. I unfortunately have moved them on. I think it was a red melon. Yeah, or the red discus. He got killed by one of the bigger ones, one of the biggest snake skins, which sucked. And his swim bladder just got messed up. And yeah, he died pretty slowly, which is sad. The two snake skins actually paired up, which I don't know if that increased the aggression. It probably did. They laid twice. They laid eggs, and fucking they were just, you know, scaring off the other fish, obviously. But yeah, after the red one died, it put me off a lot on discus, and I don't know. I didn't think they suited this tank. A 4 foot long, probably not the best tank for an adult sized discus, and they wouldn't have grown to their full potential here. So, and after I realized that, I was like, yeah, I'm probably gonna move them on and try something else. So, yeah, I recouped most of my money from the sale of that, so it wasn't too bad. I tried cichlids in here after, I had a few, but nah, it just didn't do it for me. Had them fairly small, and you know, they were just so messy. And yeah, I've had cichlids before, but I tried them and I was like, we'll see what happens, but yeah, no. So I've decided to go back to marine tank. I've changed the 4 foot into a marine setup, sort of. So that's pretty exciting. I am still running the same canister, but I've swapped out all the media. I'm running marine bivalves, some ceramic media, one sponge, and two bags of charcoal. Added a power head, and I'm running a small skimmer that's suited for, I think, a 90 litre tank. So, yeah, it is suited for a 9 litre tank. It came with one of my small nano tanks. I'm running that for now. I'm hoping to get a hang on the back aqua one skimmer, but I'm not sure when I'll get that. I wanted to run a really minimal setup. I'm really not sure with what I'm going to put in the tank yet. I'm going to try really hard not to get a tang, because I know this tank is small for it. Even at a small size, they will be prone a lot of diseases and stuff, so gonna try hard back on the tang. I know there's some smaller tangs that may be able to do well in this, but I'm still not sure. But yeah, I just wanted to run the tank on a canister only, and have the live rock as my main source of filtration. So yeah, I purchased, I actually started the tank up 12 days ago, so yeah, it's been cycling for 12 days so far. And I bought, I think that's about, it's about 17 and a half kilos of, he said 20, but it felt a bit less, of cured rock. I got it from someone on Gumtree for pretty cheap. It has some aptasia on it, so I have to look at getting rid of that. But yeah, he was shutting down his tank, and he was selling off some of his rock, so that definitely sped up the cycle by a lot. I'm also dosing Continuum, which is just like a live bacteria, just to get the whole cycle going. So yeah, I'm probably gonna add one or two fish next week, depending on my levels. There has been a spike in my ammonia, so I'm just waiting for that to go down. And then, yeah, it should be all good to add a fish or two, something small. Still deciding between an Oscillaris and a maroon clown. I know maroons can be really aggressive and territorial, but we'll see what happens. But yeah, that's pretty much it. It's the exact same tank that had a discus in it. It's actually looking quite nice with the live rock. I'm not sure on the scape. It might change. It probably will change. But yeah, And I won't have any SPS in here. I'll have some softies and maybe some LPS in here. Just easy to keep corals because I'm not running a sump or anything in there. I would like to get a sump, but it wouldn't fit in this cabinet because of just the way it's built inside. I'll show you guys another video. But I don't know, it looks good for now. The water is pretty clear. The power maker's all right. It's a Jabo power maker. It's the RW4, and it's not bad. You can push out 5,000 liters an hour, so it's all right. But yeah, it's looking all right. I can't wait to add fish and some softies. But yeah, it's pretty much up there. I'm running two lights in it. I'll show you guys that in another video as well. Just when I probably add the fish or something. But yeah, this is the main display now. I'm hoping to keep this for a while. Just gonna take it slow with this, not rushing to anything. I think that's the key with the saltwater setups, just taking your time. not adding fish too quickly. And just always checking your levels and stuff. I've done saltwater before. I had a small 36 liter nano and just, it was a disaster. didn't have any test kits. Sorry, I didn't know my salt level or anything like that. My stocking wasn't crazy or anything. I had two clowns and a coral goby and an anime. But it was too hard to take care of. There was algae everywhere. There was so much cyanobacteria. And I just lost interest in it. But that was a few years ago, that was in 2015, so I'm trying the marine setup again. I've gone a lot bigger, from 36 litres to 200. It's a 4 foot tank, 4 by 1.5 by 1.5, I think, something like that. But it's 200 litres, so it's about 50 gallons, if you're American. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Exciting times. I'll try to update this tank as regularly as possible. But yeah, really excited. So thanks for watching, guys.